right? So in our last session, we have discussed about the autocomplete text view and spinner. That is very important, right? Now, today we are going to discuss about one another important topic, and that is day-to-day you are experiencing these particular features of Android whenever you are using your Android devices, right? So today we are going to discuss about menu. So there are three types of menu we have in Android. One is option menu, another one is the pop-up menu, and third one is the context menu, right? So what do you mean by option menu? So let's quickly see the theory portion, and then we directly jump onto the coding section, how you can create it. So as you have experiencing that, at the right top corner, you have three dots, right? So when you click on that, then this kind of, you can say, menu items will pop up, right? New tab, new incognito tab, bookmarks, and all that. Okay, so the option menu is a collection of options for an activity. So option menu can be one, only one, into your activity that shows the collection of options of activity. Remember this point, right? It has a set of items that are useful to perform action, and it helps us to combine multiple actions together. So you can see over here, from these options, you can choose any of the particular option, and then if you can navigate to that particular activity. This is known as the option menu. Second type is a pop-up menu. So pop-up menu displays a list of items in a pop-up window. So suppose if I have one image, right? And when I click on that particular image, then it will show these kind of options like edit, save, delete, share, forward. Okay, so that is known as the pop-up menu. So pop-up menu appears below the view by default. In case there is no space, then you can see it appears above it, right? Otherwise it appears below it. And the third one is a context menu. So context menu is whenever you long press any particular item. So right now you have a 3D touch, right? So whenever you long press any of the particular widget, okay, element into your activity, and then this kind of menu is going to appear. So suppose here, if I long press this YouTube window, YouTube icon, so it shows me that open in a new tab, open in incognito tab, download link, remove, this kind of options it shows, right? So this is known as the context menu. So there are three basically facilities we have, okay? So first is option menu, that is this ellipsis you can see over here, right? So this is the option menu. Okay, when you click on it, it will show up the items. Second one is, suppose if I have one image or button over here, if I click on it, then it shows the particular options, list of item. And this is a third type. So when I long press any particular element in my activity, then it shows the options, right? So there are three ways we have. In menu, suppose if you want to create a menu, then these are the three main elements in that. First is the menu, second one is the item. So basically you are going to focus on these two, and third one is the group. So suppose if you want to define a menu, right? So it defines the menu that contains the option, and menu contains more than one element. So it holds the one or more elements, and it must be the root of the file. It must be the root of the file. Suppose, say, for example, here, this is one menu I have. This is my file option. Okay. This is my file option. And again, here I have a sub menu. So in this my sub menu, here I have another two items like save and save as. Okay. So it must be your root items, and items you can put. So whatever. Here you have edit, here you have a save, right? So these particular options you can put as an items, right? So now let's jump onto the particular example. So you can see how you can create the menu. So first of all, we are going to start with the option menu, right? So I have created all three applications. Okay, so you have to create a new project that you now very much aware of it. You have to go to the file, then new project, then select one empty activity. Okay, and then you just finish, then this kind of stuff will be there. Now, this is my application. Okay, so let's first of all run this. So you will get the idea what kind of activity we are going to perform. So here, when you run the application, then you can see that this is our application. Here we have three lists, right? So when I click on this, then you can see this kind of items, this kind of options you can say we have. And this is my sub menu. So whatever item I'm going to select, that will be selected over here. So right now we are only going to perform a demo purpose. So we are displaying one text message, toast message. This is my sub menu. In my file, I have two options, save and save as. Suppose I click on the save as, then it displays the save as a toast message, right? So instead of displaying a toast message, you can put the navigation to this particular thing or any function, any functionality you can put, right? So now let's see how to create this kind of menu in our application, right? So first of all, in front of us, we have, whenever you freshly create a new project, then you have this particular thing in front of you. Now here I have removed a text view from this particular thing. I don't want anything in this particular activity, right? So here there is a different scenario to create a menu. So first of all, what you need to do, you need to just jump onto this resource folder. You need to right click on it, go to the new and create Android resource directory, right? So now here, whenever you are creating Android resource directory, then you have these resource types. Up till now, we have not touched this, right? So now from this resource type, you have to select a menu, okay? Here you can give any name of this particular menu item. So for the simplicity, I have kept as a menu. So here you can see I have kept as a menu, right? So when you click on OK, then one directory will be created and one layout file will be created, right? So in this menu folder, one layout file is created. The name of that file is menu.xml. Okay, now how to put these items over here? So let's open this menu.xml file. So jump onto the code section, okay? And here into this particular code section. So as I mentioned you that you have to draw the particular navigations, what kind of options you want, right? So let me split it. Okay. Now here, what I want in my main front options, I want file, edit, and view. So these are your root items. Into that, you can put the sub items. So here, you need to see that this must be menu. Okay. These are your item. This is our first file, save and save as. This is our second option. And this is our third option, right? So suppose if I want to put a fourth option over here, then what I need to do, I need to write item. Then I need to provide the ID, what ID I want, right? So here, suppose I want a print, okay? After that, I need to set the title. So I can set the title and you need to give the name, set that is a print, okay? and then close it. Right? So here you can see side by side. Now we have fourth option, print option over here. So likewise, you can add as many options you want. Now to create a sub items, right? So here you can see that we have item tag. Okay, we have item tag. In that, we want a sub menu. So you can see over here, we need to create a new sub menu, right? And here you can see that in that menu, again, two items we have, that is save and save as. Are we clear? Right? So this way you can create a menu and a sub menu. Okay, this is very simple, guys. And all the three, you can say things, some of the things will be very common, all the three menus, right? So this is our design completed. You see, automatically, as you put, all the designs are going to be generated. Now, let's jump onto the coding section. So now here, we have not created anything in our activity main. We have created a separate menu file, right? So that ellipsis will come automatically, right? So how it comes automatically? So it because of this. So whenever a default code section we have, so this much is the default code section we have, right? Now we are related, we are dealing with the option menu. So we need to create one method. We need to override one method, that is onCreatePanelMenu, right? So here you can see that to override methods, it is very easy. Very easy. You have to just enter control option. Then you jump into the override methods and you just need to remember the name and then you just click and press OK. All the methods are going to be generated automatically. So this particular line I have not written, right? So this particular line is automatically generated for me. Okay, now you need to remember what kind of method you want to create. So here we are dealing with the option menu. So we need to on create panel menu. So here one menu inflator is there to lay out that particular menu, right? So here we are going to get that particular menu inflator and we are inflated, right? So now here you need to provide two arguments. One is which layout, for which layout you are inflating and what items you are inflating. So here r.menu.menu. So menu is our XML file name. So which layout? This layout, menu.xml. So that you have to provide over here, right? And then you have to provide the particular argument over here, menu, this argument. Okay, and return true. Now, our menu will be there. Now, another functionality is there. Whenever I select any option, then I want to display the toast message, right? So for that, again, you need to override one another method, that is on options item selected. You need to remember this, right? So whenever you are dealing with the particular option menu, then on options item selected, you have to override, right? And we are passing argument as an item. So whatever menu items we have, so that we pass as an argument. So this line again is automatically generated. Remember, guys, you don't need to write it. Now we need to write our logic. So here I have used elsiflater, right? So first of all, what we need to do? So suppose if I'm selecting a file or if I'm selecting a print, so that particular option I have selected that I want to get. So for that, I'm getting item ID. So one automatically unique ID will be generated for that. And that will be fetched with the use of, you see, this item dot get item, and we are storing that ID into one integer variable. So item ID. Now we just need to compare that with our particular options. So if my item ID equal to r.id.file, so what you have to write the same code for all the options, right? If it matches, then what I need to do, I need to print a toast message. So toast dot make text is equals to this context. You have to print a message length long and so, and then return true. Right? Else if, similarly, you have to follow this particular logic for all the items, because we want to display whatever we want to click, that toast message should be displayed. And at the default, at the last, we need to return, because here we have to return boolean. So return on option item selected items. Okay, so it's a very simple logic, guys, right? You just need to remember these two methods: on create panel menu to inflate the menu over the activity, and option item selected to get the particular option from the menu. Okay, so as you can see now, if you run this code again, that's it, guys. This particular you can say example logic is over. Now if you execute this code, then you can see simply now we have a print option over here. When I click, because we have not written anything, but when I click on a view, then it will display the view, right? So this way you can create the option menu. I hope it is very clear to you, and a logic is very simple. This much logic is required only to create the option menu. Okay, now if you are clear, then we can jump onto the another example, that how you can create a pop-up menu, right? Okay, so let's jump onto the another example, that is our pop-up menu. So side by side, you are also getting the idea that what is the difference between these three menus. So let's open our another example, that is a pop-up menu, and open in this window. Now, this is our pop-up menu example, guys. In this example, let's first execute this example so you can see the difference between these two, how this particular application is working. So here I took one pop-up menu button. You can take any image, right? So when I click on it, and then one menu is going to pop up. That is for share, reply, forward. Okay, so when I click on this, then it will please trail a toast message. But the main thing is here, there is no ellipsis you can see over here, that three dots, right? We have a menu attached with this particular element, right? So whenever you require this kind of activity, then you should go for the pop-up menu. Now, how to create it? So again, you have to create one button. So it is very simple. You just give the name and ID to that particular button. Okay, so as I given here, after that, again, you just need to go to the resource folder, new, and Android resource directory. Okay, and when you click on this, then again, you just need to go for the menu. Right, so here, by default name menu will be there, but I have changed it as a pop-up underscore menu, right, to demonstrate the difference. So once you click on OK, so here you just need to write pop-up underscore menu. So that menu file will be created, right? Now we have a directory menu and we have one XML file, right? So here again, let's open the XML file. In this particular thing, you can see the creation of menu is very similar. Whatever we did in our option menu, all the things you need to do over here, same thing. If you want to create a sub menu, then you can also create a menu between the items, right? Though it is appear as an ellipsis over here, whenever we actually run the application, it will not be there. Because by writing a logic, so whenever we inflate it, when we inflate a menu, then we are attaching, we bind that particular menu with our element. Okay, that's why. But at the particular stage, you can see all the menu creation thing is same. I told you that all the menu creation will be same in all three types, right? Now, let's jump on to only this much design is required for this application. Now jump onto the logic. So again, we have this particular logic auto created. Okay, but here I have created one function. You can see that show popup, and we are passing a view. So here, instead of menu inflator, right now we need to use popup menu class. So you can see over here, guys, show popup and popup. So popup menu, create the object of it, pass the context and view argument, and set the item click listener on this particular popup. Because whenever we click on that, at the same time we are going to open the popup. So here you need to set on menu item click listener. This you need to remember, right? Now we inflate it. So whenever we inflate it, which file, which XML file we are inflating? Popup underscore menu. So that XML file name you have to provide over here. And then just popup menu dot show, right? So by writing this much logic, your menu will be there. Now what is required? Our another functionality is, when I click on a particular option, then I need to display the toast message. So again, here I need to override on menu item click, on menu item click method. This you need to remember. And similarly, again, we are fetching the item ID, storing it into the item ID variable, and we are comparing it. We are comparing it with our options. And after that, we are displaying a toast message. So here, context, your message, and the duration, and dot show. And at the last, we are returning the false. Add is required for this boolean. Okay, so if you write this much logic, then your application is ready, right? So you can see this is very easy, guys. So now if you execute your code, and if you see that we have one button, this element, then we click on it, one options menu will be generated. When I click on it, and then it will display the message. Okay, guys. And now let's jump onto the last example, our context menu example, that in which situation you can use this. So let's open the context menu example. Okay, so in this particular example, we are going to discuss about the context menu. So you can see over here, I have kept one text. So suppose whatever text message you are getting into your WhatsApp or in Messenger, whatever, right? So when you long press on it, right, then one option menu will be generated, forward, reply, whatever, right? So if you want that kind of facility, then you can go for the context menu, right? But here the requirement is you need to hold that particular element, long press you have to put compulsory, then your menu will be pop up. Whereas in pop up, you just need to click on that particular element and then it will be pop up, right? So that you need to remember. So here we have one text menu, array text view. And when I long press on this text view, then my pop-up will be generated. Now again, you need to go to the resource directory. You need to create one Android resource directory, and resource type you have to select as a menu. And here you just need to type context menu. Okay. And .xml file will be generated whenever you click on OK. Right. So now we have this XML file. So again, we need to create the menu. So same thing will be there as we saw in our previous example, that here you have menu tag. Three menu options we have. One is share, another one is reply, and third one is the forward. So that is very easy to create. Now, the logic will be different. Okay. Now here, the first thing is we took a text view. So we need to find view by ID. And then you need to register that for the context menu. So suppose if I have text view 2 over here, and I want to create another context menu for that particular text view, then I need to register for context menu text view 2. So for how many controls you want to create a context menu, for that each and every control you have to register it. So register for context menu, right? And then which control? So by text view I want to attach. Okay, now your menu, how you can inflate it? So here there is a different constructor we have, different methods we have. So on create context menu method. So in these three menu examples, you need to remember these three methods for inflating the menu and three methods for selecting the items. Okay. So total 3 + 3, 6 methods you need to remember, guys, only. Now here, what you need to do? Here we need to inflate our menu. So which menu item we are going to inflate? So that is our context menu. So here we have already created a context menu. So that will be inflated. Now, after inflated, what we need to do? We need to select the item, and according to that, we need to print a toast message. So here in this, you can see that we need to override on context item selected, right? On context item selected, because we are going to deal with the context menu item. Now here again, we are fetching the ID, right? So, and after that, we are comparing that ID with our options, and accordingly we are printing the message. And here return super on context item selected item you can put, right? So now, let's see how this example is working. So here we have context menu. So if I click on it, nothing is happening. I'm clicking on it, nothing is happening. But when I press long on that particular, then a menu is going to open, right? And suppose if I want to forward this message, and I just need to click on the forward. Right? So this way you can create the menu items into Android application, any Android application, and this is very much required feature in each and every you can say application, Android application, you require this kind of facility.